Uncovering bias in machine learning could just involve great storytelling. I'm Tanya Hall for ZDNet and Tech Republic, and joining me is Kathy Klotz Guest, founder of keepingithuman.com. Welcome, Kathy.
Thank you for having me. Happy to be here.
So give us a summary of your resume, including the journey from working in Sunnyvale cherry orchards to becoming a business comedian.
Yes. Well, I started in tech right after college. I also started in comedy. So I was parallel pathing it. I was working in marketing and communications during the day. And at night, 5-6 nights a week, I was hitting comedy stages. And so little by little, I was taking concepts from the comedy world and putting them smack into the heart of communications, because comedy is storytelling. And that's what every great technology company needs, is great human storytelling. So I found that that path was very synergistic. It just worked. One worked with the other. And so it kind of, you know, it's a little bit of alchemy. I think my resume is a little bit of alchemy.
You're actually on a panel at South by Southwest coming up to discuss how unconscious bias in machine learning isn't funny. Can you give us an example of how you've seen bias play out in machine learning and artificial intelligence?
Sure. There's so many stories. A couple that stick out in my mind are Hello Barbie from Mattel, where they were recording children talking to the doll. And overwhelmingly, it was little girls, of course. And hi, my name is Barbie. What's your name? What's your middle name? What's this? What's that? And collecting all this information on little girls, and it was being uploaded to a server. There was a beauty pageant that was held online, and it overwhelmingly, out of about 44 contestants, overwhelmingly all the winners were white. Actually, more than that, but of the 44 winners, they were overwhelmingly white. And this was contestants from all over the world. And what ended up happening was it was discovered that what was programmed into it was standards of beauty based on Caucasian features. So this stuff, it happens. And it was beauty.ai. And it was all based on machine learning and AI.
Are we being rigorous enough in screening data sets for bias? I mean, is bias awareness reaching the engineers and decision makers that can actually make a difference?
It's starting to. I think we're really having robust discussions about it. And I think for a long time it wasn't. We don't know what we don't know, hence unconscious bias. However, I think we are now aware of what those problems are. And I think a lot of companies are actually leaning into the conversations, and they're having them. And they're not just having them at the developer level, which has to happen. They're having them at the board level and at the C-suite level. And I think there's been a disconnect, because I think a lot of companies don't know the questions to ask, even in the C-suite, even at the board level. They're not sure what to ask and what to look for. That's starting to change, because we recognize that the data sets of today, if extrapolated as is into the future, will carry that bias forward. So I think it's changed.
What responsibility do AI scientists have to make it possible to audit their algorithms? And what about the intellectual property aspects of that transparency?
It's a great question. And that's one that's being, you know, that conversation is being had all over the place. Well, I think more and more there has to be some transparency of data sets. And you know that they're resisting. A lot of data scientists are totally resisting. And here's the problem, is that we can't go in and say, hey, if we can't look under the hood, here's where the potential biases are. And so what's happening now is that a lot of companies are, of their own volition, having to have checklists and have internal audits and bring in people internally to ask those questions. Will more and more companies do that? I think so. I think there's a lot of pressure, especially when companies are being accused of bias and they're saying, no, we're not biased. Our data's not biased. And they're saying, well, prove it. Let us audit your data and let's see. So I think you're going to see more and more of that. That's not going anywhere.
What suggestions do you have for those implementing AI on how to build and test for bias-free systems? What questions really should we be asking?
There's a lot of questions. There's a lot of places to start, and it's such a big thing. I think it first starts with asking questions of what do we know? What don't we know? Where are our blind spots? Which is as important a question to ask as what are the biases we have? What could be there? What are the blind spots? And I think it starts with a checklist that looks for these things and just goes on down the list. Could we have a blind spot around race, gender, people with disabilities? Could we have, any number of biases? It starts with having diversity in machine learning because 90% of machine learning developers are male. It starts with having a team internally in companies to ask these questions. And a lot of companies don't have an independent arm outside of developers to even ask the questions. And they don't have to be AI experts, but there should be some kind of group internally in a company to say, hey, have you thought about A, B, and C? And we need that. And we need that accountability all the way up to the C-suite. They may not have understand all the details. They're trusting their technology departments, but they should know enough to be able to ask the questions. Hey, have we looked at all these different things? So diversity, going down the list for all these different things, making sure we're transparent and having, if need be, other people look at that data. And that one, of course, as you said, is very touchy because people are very hung up on IP, but I think it's going to have to be a forced issue.
China and the U.S. compete in AI technology, but they're also at odds strategically and militarily. To what degree should we trust or mistrust a Chinese AI system to give Americans the right answers?
That's a great question. It's a hard one to answer because there are no standards by which we all play, together. There is no common standard of checklists that everybody uses and agrees to use. So I think we have to be circumspect. I think we have to be smart about it. I think we should have standards and say, hey, if we're using your technology, you should be transparent. What is in it? What are you collecting? How are you collecting? I think the demand for greater transparency, it makes sense. I mean, I think that's only going to grow because we have reason to wonder about it. And our own companies as well, I think they would ask the same questions.
All right, Kathy, what's the secret to telling a great machine learning story?
I think the secret is in remembering that humans program machines and that we are fallible. And because we have bias, chances are, unless we've gone through a checklist and we've really looked at the data, there's probably some bias in there somewhere, and admitting it and being honest about it. Because every great AI fail story where there's been bias, you look back after the fact and you go, oh yeah, we should have thought of that. So I think the key is just being really open and leaning into those failures as learning lessons and going there and being honest about it, just honest about the human failings, because we all have them. Humans are like coffee makers. We all got filters. And so all those stories have great, great lessons too.
Kathy Klotz, guest, founder of KeepingItHuman.com. Thanks for joining. If somebody wants to connect with you, maybe they want to find out more about your work, how can they do that?
You can go to KeepingItHuman.com. You can also find me on the socials. I'm over at Twitter at Kathy Klotz, guest, no hyphen, and same on LinkedIn.
Well, I will certainly have to follow you. And if you guys want to find more of my interviews, you can do that right here on ZDNet or Tech Republic, or go to my website, TanyaHall.net. I've got links to all my social sites. Thanks for watching.